Hey, I'm not from San Francisco. I'm from Oakland.
Oh, say
okay,
it,
from
say
Oakland.
It. Okay.
It's okay, though. Okay.
Preface that.
That's how I feel about the whole situation. If you want it, you want it. If she ain't putting it down right, you gotta go find another person to get it. If
there
your
you
girlfriend
go.
Is not doing it, what she gotta do, if she's not making you happy, you gotta go find that motherfucker who makes you happy. And that's
there
why
you go,
cheating, that's why you're
I like
cheating.
So, Monique, that's you walk in. Monique, you walk in on your man have getting down while you got off of work, and he tell you it's a gene that made him do it. What are you going to do?
Wait, say it again.
If you come home and your man is doing somebody else, your best friend, your girlfriend, and he say, nah, baby, it wasn't me. It's these genes. My mama passed it down to me. Do y'all stay together?
Nigga, please get the fuck out of my house.
Put your jeans
not
on.
In your jeans. It's not in your jeans.
Thank
it's
you.
Not, I took sixth A class math. It is not in your damn jeans. You just a man hoe.
I don't know
okay.
if I like that.
Well, thanks a lot for your call. I appreciate that.
Don't say thanks
Miss
on
Oakland.
That. I am love not a man hoe.
A man hoe.
I like women. Don't have nothing to do with being a hoe.
But now, okay, so her point was that. If he's not getting what he's getting at home, he's got to go out and get it somewhere.
Yeah.
But what if he is? Because I know people who have healthy sexual relationships at home, and they will go out and tell all kinds of, oh, you know, my wife ain't giving it to me, or, you know, we on bad terms, I'm sleeping on the couch. And it is all a lie just to get some new kitten.
We love the new stuff. We want to see what yours feel like. I wish somebody would call in. One of the dudes call in and please tell
right,
these women
the truth.
Right,
that's the dopamine.
No, it ain't no dopamine. It's the. We got Tony from Miami on the phone. What's up, Tony?
What's going on, y'all? I think there's like actually three conversations going on. Lady Soul was right on point, but I gotta say, the Monique out in Oakland, she was a walking contradiction. How is she gonna sit there and say if the woman ain't putting it down right, then he's right to do whatever he's got to do? But her man is on a whole other category because he's got to go. When he just did what she said was okay.
Mm-hmm.
But
well, you got a point there. I didn't
make it conversation. Question. Concern one is it a gene? I think there is when Lady Soul was talking about the addictive personality, it is attributed to that whether people want to appreciate it or not. Do people still go out there and do what they want to do? Of course. And you got single men out there that we gonna date and be promiscuous and hit whatever we want to hit. But when you decide that you're going to get married, you're supposed to set all that other stuff aside.
But don't you think there's just another excuse that somebody could use to get out of a situation?
But
I don't disagree with you that you can use it as an excuse, whether it is an addiction or not. You still can get away with using it as an excuse.
Okay.
Right. Thanks a lot for your call, Tony.
Thank you, man.
Now, but what they're saying, and this would be like alcoholism, okay? There's something that is in your chemical makeup, a dopamine receptor gene called DRD4 that gives you a higher propensity toward addiction, toward gambling addiction, toward alcohol addictions. Now, that doesn't mean that you can say, oh, well, you know, I got this gene, so I just can't help myself.
I'm gonna say it. Trust me.
Like, you still have to be a human and make choices for yourself. Mm-hmm. And if you have some sort of addiction, you have to acknowledge that addiction and get help for it if you need it.
We are
so
a country,
that doesn't make it an excuse.
We are
excuse.
A country that wants to lean on excuse on everything. I didn't do this because when I was little, my mama, no, you did it because you stupid, and that's why you did that. On the phone.
Will from Minnesota. What's up, Will?
Will.
Hey, how y'all doing? That was good.
Damn, you niggas is relaxed for real.
It's all good. What's up, Will?
Nah, I wanted to say, you know, just like Eddie Murphy said back in the day, man, it's a dick thing, you know. My dick may want to go hit the fine chick I see at the mall, but you know, I'm married, you know, my wife puts it down, but you know, you got to put the head in the control of the dick, man. That's all.
I will not.
That's why you got all those babies, Speedy. Thanks a lot for the call, Will.
It's Caldwell.
Caldwell.
Oh, it's all you said, Caldwell. Hilarious. 877-210-6106. We are talking about on our iSex part about in your DNA, supposedly. That you can say, hey, it's in my genes that I'm a cheater and I like to have sex with more than one person.
Yes.
And I don't believe that's true. Brandy believed that it could be in your genes.
I'm saying that I do believe that there is, I do think that there's a possibility that something in your chemical makeup will make you more likely to
you're
be
horny.
One of these people.
Horny.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Why are some people hornier than others?
Because they ain't getting it.
No, that's not necessarily true.
I don't get it as much. I wish I could get it every day. All day, every day.
But, I mean, some people have the opportunity to have it every day, and they just have no desire for it.
They don't want
it.
To do that person. Line up 12 women. They'll pick somebody. If I had 12 to pick from every day, somebody going to get picked.
Every day. Every All day. Right, back to the phone lines. We got Juan from Atlanta.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that, you know, it's nothing better than pussy but some new pussy. And
See?
That's the bottom line.
Thank you, man.
But sex is sex. Love is love. Those two different things.
Yes.
But once you know that, I think it's like the gift and the curse. And the more you get, the more you know that. And it's
mm-hmm.
harder to just be with one person and not want another pussy ever in your life. So, I mean, there's nothing better than pussy. It's the best thing in the world. But the only thing better than it is some new pussy.
Thank you. Thank you. Somebody finally called in. Appreciate that. That was a great phone call.
Thanks a lot for the call, Juan.
Great phone
but
call.
But do you not think, okay, so I think it's funny, too.
Like, you cute. If we was dating, trust me. Let's put it this way. My man played basketball for San Antonio Spurs.
Which man?
Point guard.
Anyway, some dude. Some dude played basketball.
And he's dating whatever her name is. What's her name? Tony Parker.
Okay, yeah, and he's dating.
Well, he's married. And they're about to get divorced because he got some new hookup. She fine is all outdoors, and he still messed around on her. Why? Because it's new.
Dopamine.
It's new dopamine.
Dopamine.
877-2106-106 the number. On the phone, Big Ben out of Kentucky.
Hey,
what's up, Big
Ben?
Hey, what's up going on, Brandy? What's up, Speedy?
What's happening, Pimp Sauce in the can?
Shit, I can't call no shots, man. But like my man said, like you said, Speedy, man. It ain't no gene. Men like variety. That's what we like. Now, I like to not pour this damn, but Brandy, come on, you running a close second right there, baby. I mean.
She's blushing right now, Big Ben.
That's good. She didn't even call me and wish me a happy birthday yesterday. I'm kind of upset with that.
Happy birthday, Big Ben.
Thank you, baby.
That's a little soft right there, Ben.
I love it.
Yeah, whatever. But yeah, man, it ain't no G, man. It's just me and like variety, man. It's like a crackhead saying that, oh, I got the crackhead gene, that's why I'm a crackhead.
Yeah.
Me and Chica, you know, we like it.
But that's what they're saying, is that people who are addicted to crack or alcohol or whatever are that, like, they have a tendency to be addictive. They have addictive personalities. There's something in their DNA that makes them addicted. So basically, thanks for the phone call, Big Ben, and happy birthday.
That's like saying being an alcoholic is a disease. No, you drank alcohol.
It's pretty much widely accepted as a disease.
Because people took it as a disease instead of just saying, I shouldn't be drinking.
Well, I think there's people that drink too much, you know, and then there's people that do have a problem. Don't tell nobody.
So what happens when you get drunk? It go down?
No, nothing.
You become new? Okay.
No, but I do think that there are people that drink a lot. And then there are people who are chemically addicted to alcohol. Like, they have physical issues whenever they don't get alcohol. Like, you know.
Or when they do get it.
When they don't get it. Or when they do. Actually, yeah. Both. Both sides of the coin. I actually just had a situation with this in my own personal life with somebody that I know.
Hmm.
And this person was sober for 4 years, and they had one drink, and they turned into a monster right off the bat, like immediately. And their body, I think their whole body, their whole person, everything, there's something in their chemistry.
Mm. Yeah, they maybe it's just you being around them. All right, because I didn't have a drink twice since you've been here. In the New Orleans, we got John on the phone. What's up, John?
Yo, what's good?
What's happening, man?
On the conversation, dog.
I gotta
agree with her a little bit in the fact that the withdrawal symptoms, if I get pussy withdrawal, I got to have it. I got to have pussy. Got to put it on the lip. Got to get it on the chin. I'm an angry motherfucker. I don't like to deal with nobody. So there is part of that rule that you can be addicted to it. But it ain't no gene, dog. You got to get what you got to get, you know? I mean, it's like going, I take trips to Miami a lot.
Yeah.
But Miami ain't the same place it was for me 10 times ago.
Gotcha.
But if I visit Philly,
yeah,
I'm trying to
new.
Get that Philly flavor.
Yeah, there you go.
And that's
going
to be the best trip to me right then and there.
And if you don't, you having withdrawal symptoms.
Having a few withdrawal symptoms.
I like that. Got to have it on his lip.
Maybe they should make a flavored soda for guys that need it on their lips.
I got that.
You got it?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
All right, thanks a lot for the call.
It's called pee in a can.
Pee in a can. Yeah. I wasn't going to say it.
Not pee in the can, but.
No, I know.
P-U-S-S-Y.
I know what the P stands for. That's why I said I wasn't going to say it.
It's been a great show.
You know.
Hey, Ricky, what you doing?
Yeah, what's up, Ricky?
Hey, dog. Hey, church.
Church.
I'm working church.
Thanks a lot, you guys.
Shout out to Ricky,
too. Yeah, shout out to Ricky Harris. We'll see you next week.
You got to get that money. Hey, Christmas coming up. You got to get that money.
I tell you.
What are you doing this week?
I'm just going to be chilling around house, on my computer, on my Twitter. I've been away from it for a while, so I'm going to get back on there and talk to some of you people that hit me up. Brandi McGee, facebook.com/BrandiMcGee. That's BrandiMagee. Mm-hmm. And twitter.com/BrandiMcGee. And what about you, Speedy?
I'm actually, this Friday after I do the radio show, I'm performing for police officers.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Where?
In LA, LA Police Department. So they asked me to send a contract with my name on. I was like, no.
Now
they're going to arrest me when I get there. I'm Speedy.
Leave your paraphernalia?
They said, well, you going to write you a check. I said, no, pimp, need that cash. But yes, for the police officers, for their annual Christmas party.
Don't get arrested.
I got jokes.
I know you got jokes, but you also got warrants.
Yeah.
So, yeah, be careful with that.
Well, I'll let them know that Captain Awesome.
Go in as Captain Awesome.
It's been a great show. We want to give a shout out to all the people who called in. We appreciate the phone calls. Appreciate you listening to us.
Definitely. And hey, we'll be back next Wednesday on the Foxhole Comedy Corner.
Yeah, it's been your boy Speedy.
And it's Brandi McGee, aka Princess Wildflower.
And I'm Rick Dog. Long Beach Dog.
Nice.
I love it. All right, we out here. Thank you. God bless.